Deadly Tarantula Girl coming to you to bring you a different type of arachnid today. This animal is known by many names: the whip scorpion, Krampus, vinegaroon, or the scientific name, Mastigioproctus giganteus giganteus. Let's take a look. I've said these animals are essentially harmless to humans. Let me show you just how harmless they are. This is the proper way to pick a vinegaroon up. So you want to very gently and slowly, basically just put one hand in front and one hand behind, and just let them, a little freaked out right now, it's okay. Just let them walk up onto your hand. They can hold on pretty well. This subspecies of Giganteus giganteus is American. These animals reside in Arizona, Florida, New Mexico, Texas, and Oklahoma. There are a few that go down into Mexico, although there's a different subspecies once you get further into Mexico. This animal's body, without the flagellum, measures at about 5 centimeters, which is pretty long if you're not used to bugs and you see a giant thing like this crawling around. They are carnivorous. They are insectivores, meaning they eat other bugs smaller than them. And the acetic acid that they excrete is about 85%, I guess you would say, and is excreted from the base of the tail, to where vinegar that you would buy to have in your kitchen is probably around 5%. And this vinegar is more concentrated, but again, really poses no danger to humans. And I've been around them while they secrete the vinegar before, and basically it just stinks a little bit. Did I scare you? This animal is using the front legs kind of as feelers, and I kind of accidentally pinched one of them down a tiny bit. Freaked it out. They're so long. It's feeling out in front of it. And you guys might notice my beautiful henna that I got. I was just in Albuquerque for a belly dance event this weekend, and I went and saw an amazing artist named Gigi, and she owns Luna Serena Body Art by Gigi. She has a Facebook page. So if you're anywhere in or around New Mexico, I would recommend anybody to go and see her for face and body painting, henna, jaguar, or ink tattooing. She is an ink tattooist as well. Amazing woman. Her husband is in the very popular band Blind Drive, so check them out as well. That's with a double D and a Y. Hope you guys liked meeting this very different arachnid. Interesting, huh? In my area, this animal is most commonly referred to as a vinegaroon. Many people pronounce it vinegarone. And they are non-venomous and essentially harmless, although they can spray a vinegary smelling acid. And I know that sounds really dangerous, but it's basically like kind of like getting strong vinegar on your skin, which can be damaging to the exoskeleton of an insect. But on human skin, you would just want to wash it off. And it's primarily the smell that's kind of like, ooh, that's stinky. So this is an invertebrate. Oh, somebody wants to go for a little ride. And they're not a spider, however, they are an invertebrate. This is actually a pedipalp. This is actually a first leg that doubles as an antenna. And then there are 3 other pairs of legs. So as an arachnid, it has 4 pairs of legs, a pedipalp, and then the body is divided into 2 primary sections, just like a tarantula of the prosoma, opisthosoma. They do have 8 eyes, 8 legs, double segmented body, and pedipalps. Similar to tarantula, they're just shaped quite a bit differently. Hope you guys like this one. This was the first vin cut of the season. I really enjoy hunting this species because they're so like big and creepy looking, but they're totally harmless. I think they're really neat. as I mentioned earlier, the American species is Giganteus giganteus. It goes into Mexico a little bit, but further into Mexico, there's another subspecies. If you have access to that animal in the wild or know anything about it, I'd love to hear about it. So comment pictures or comments about that below, or email me at deadlytarantulagirl@yahoo.com. Hope you guys like this one, and I'll see you soon.